Now we are going to do question number 19th of your text. Triangle ABC is equilateral. The side BC is trisected at D, and we have to prove that 9AD square is equal to 7AB square. We have to prove 9AD square is equal to 7AB square. This is what we are asked to prove. Triangle ABC is equilateral, and we have the side BC is trisected at D. And to prove that 9AD square is equal to 7AB square. Now first we'll draw the triangle that is equilateral triangle. All of you pay attention. This is the equilateral triangle. All the three sides will be of same length. We'll mark it as A, B, C. And then they're telling that the side BC is trisected at D. We'll mark a point D, which means that BD is 1/3 of the length of BC. Trisected means three equal parts. So this is 1/3 part, and the remaining will be 2/3 part. That will make as a whole. So trisect, bisect, if D would have bisected means half, trisected. So this length up till here is BC by 3. This trisected part, the side BC is trisected at D. So this is 1/3 of the total side BC. 1/3 of the total side BC. Now what we are going to do, to prove this we need a construction. So we can write given. What is given to us? Given is triangle ABC is equilateral. And we have BD as 1/3 of BC. That is given to us. To prove, now we have to prove that 9AD square should be equal to 7AD square. This is what we have to prove. So to make, you need a little, for solving this sum you need a construction. Construction will be, draw AE, the perpendicular from A to BC. Draw AE perpendicular to BC. So now we will start with the proof. Now in the proof, if you notice, AEB is a right angle triangle because AE is drawn perpendicular to BC. Now by property of equilateral triangle, AE, the perpendicular, which is the height, also bisects the base. In question number 15 we had done that the perpendicular drawn from a vertex to a opposite side of A, opposite side of an equilateral triangle, also bisects the base, which means that total length of BE is half of BC. BE length is half of BC, means BC by 2. So now in this triangle we have a relation that here BD is equal to BC by 3 and BE is equal to BC by 2 or half of BC. So if we want to find this length is for, because we need to line, we have to bring into the question, it is given AD and AB. So we have to draw a line AD, join AD. ADE is an equilateral triangle. ADE is an equilateral triangle, AB is an equilateral triangle, and this length from here to here is half of BC. So now we know BE is half of BC, BD is 1/3 of BC, so we can calculate the length DE. So what will be DE? DE will be BE minus BD. So BE is BC by 2 minus BC by 3, BD is BC. So if you take LCM 6, it is 3BC minus 2BC, that is equal to BC by 6. So you got DE's length. This narrow gap's length DE is BC by 6. So now we will be using this DE's value in our proof. So we have found it out. these two relations we have, this is drawn by construction, and B, this was given to us. So you have to write the reason. This is by construction. I'm writing in short over here. Construction, you write full. So now we have this value of DE is equal to BC by 6. So this is our equation 1 for the time. So now let us continue. Now in triangle ADE, in triangle, we can write little more up. In triangle ADE, can we write AD square as AE square plus A square plus D square? This is by Pythagoras theorem. So in triangle ADE, it being a right angle triangle, AD is the hypotenuse. So it will be AE square plus D square. Now AE is the height. AE is the height of the equilateral triangle. So AE square, AD square, I can now write again. AE square is the height. So height of an equilateral triangle is root 3 by 2 into side square. AE is root 3 by 2 into side. That is the formula for height. So if you know this, it's easier for you. Root 3 by 2 side, or you can calculate by Pythagoras theorem AE square. But if this is useful, the height, the formula for the height of an equilateral triangle is root 3 by 2 into side, and square was existing, so we did square. And DE we have found out BC by 6 whole square. D square means we only DE is BC by 6. D square, BC by 6 whole square. Now expand this. Can we write instead of side root 3 by 2? If you take root 3 by 2, side of the equilateral triangle can be AB. I can take any side of the equilateral triangle. So AB is one side. Why I am trying to write AB? Because in the question it is given to show a relation between AD and AB. So you also in your proof try to bring in AB and retain AD. So we have AD square is equal to root 3 by 2 AB square, the side. And instead of BC, in an equilateral triangle all three sides are same. So instead of BC by 6, I can write again AB by 6 whole square. Because since BC is equal to AB in an equilateral triangle. This is a property where I can substitute one side for the other. So we have got AD square as root 3 by 2 AB square plus AB by 6. In place of BC, AB is written because all sides are same. And taken side AB also AB square. Now we will continue from here. So our last sentence, the equation that we had got was AD square. We have got AD square as root 3 by 2. Root 3 by 2 into A square, that is AB square as a side, plus we have got AB by 6 whole square. Now what is this expansion? All of you pay attention. Root 3 square is only 3. 2 square is 4. AB square is AB square. Plus only AB square is AB square. 6 square is 36. And this remains AD square, it continues. So AD square, now we can take LCM of 4 and 36 is 36. So 4 into 9, 9 into 3, 27 AB square plus AB square. So we have AD square is equal to 28 AB square by 36. So 28 and 36 will cancel by 4. 4749. So you are getting AD square as 7AB square by 7 by AB square by 9 cross multiply. So 9AD square is equal to 7AB square. This was asked to be proved. 9AD square is 7AB square. So hence. Now you see everywhere we are solving these sums by certain properties and by applying Pythagoras theorem. So what you have to do, this exercise, after going through the video carefully, you see this exercise 10 and work out the sums. First few sums are easy, direct, you can apply Pythagoras theorem. But the sums thereafter, go through the examples, then you know the proper working. Try to solve out the sums and first write this in your classwork copy, because as I've said before, the classwork is your reference, would be the reference for your exam. And then work out the sums, and then if you have doubt, you can ask the doubts to and clarify your doubts. Thank you.